Step 2, adding pages, subpages, links, and images. Welcome to the second video on creating and developing an e-portfolio for the Graduation with Leadership Distinction program at the University of South Carolina. The goal of this video is to teach you to format your site by adding pages, subpages, links, and images. If you've used the pre-designed template for your e-portfolio, you probably won't need to add any pages or subpages. Starting from sites.google.com, click on the name of the site you created for your e-portfolio. Click on the New Page icon in the top right-hand section of the page. The icon has a plus sign in it. The first page we need to create is the Insights page. Type Insights in the Name Your Page box and click Create at the top of the page. This will take you to the page editing screen where you may rename or add text to your page before saving it. Go ahead and click the blue Save button on the top right-hand side of the screen. Our goal right now is to build the pages before we edit them. Once you've saved your Insights page, follow the same steps to create your Analysis and Leadership pages. Now that you've created your Insights, Analysis, and Leadership pages, it's time to add subpages. The subpages that you'll be using in your e-portfolio will be the individual insights that you choose to write about. Right now, we're going to create 4 subpages titled Insight 1, Insight 2, Insight 3, and Insight 4 as placeholders. Once you decide what the titles of these insights will be, you can rename them. To create a subpage, click on the Add Page icon from the home page of your site. Name the subpage, for example, Insight 1. The difference between pages and subpages is where the page is located. The default setting for creating a page in a Google site, found in the Select a Location section at the bottom, is Put Page at the top level. Underneath that, you will see a selection for Put Page Under blank. The page that is listed in bold is this option. Is by default whatever page you were on before you clicked the Add Page icon. If it isn't your Insights page, click on Choose a Different Location and select your Insights page. This is where all of your individual Insights pages should be located. Once you've done that, click Create and then Save. When you are finished with this step, you should have an About Me page, an Insights page with 3 or 4 individual subpages, an Analysis page, and a Leadership page. Now that your pages are created and in the proper place, you can start adding the text and artifacts to your portfolio. From the main page of your site, choose the page you'd like to edit in the left sidebar. Click on the pencil icon to edit the page. Here you can type directly into the body of the page, or you can copy and paste from another source. If you paste your pasted text and it doesn't look the way you want it to, you can try highlighting the text and using the Remove Formatting button on the toolbar at the top of the page. It looks like an underlined capital T with an X on it. This will remove any existing formatting the text may have to allow you to format it in the way you want it to look on your site. You want to do as much formatting as possible using the preset default text styles already available in Google Sites. At the top of the screen, click on Format. Here you can see different selections for preset formatting. These defaults are determined by your site template and will change if you customize the theme. We discuss changing the look and feel of your site, including themes, templates, and customizations, in the final video of this series. If you know HTML and would like to use that to edit your site, there is an HTML option in the toolbar at the top of the screen. Next, we'll show you how to embed a link to an external website into the text of your site. In the text that you've entered into the body of the page, highlight the text that you want to be the link. On the top toolbar, click the Link button. It looks like 2 circles connected by a line or a chain. You can also click Insert and then click Link in the drop-down menu. In the Create Link function, you have a few options. You can link directly to another page within your site or to an external website. To link directly to another page in your site, you would select that page from the site map. To link to an external website, click on Web Address in the left-hand sidebar and either type or paste the URL in the Link to this URL box. At the bottom of the screen, you have the option to set the link to open in a new window. One thing to note is that if you use this option, you will need to make a note of it by your link so that site visitors know that the link will open in a new window. Once you've entered the link, click OK. From the page editor, we can also add a picture to the page. It's a good idea to crop and resize any images you'll be adding prior to uploading them. That way the file size is smaller and doesn't take too long to load. However, there are some image editing tools in the page editor that you can use once you've already added the image to your page. To add an image, click in the body where you want the picture to go, and then click Insert at the top of the page. In the drop-down menu, click Image. In the Add an Image function, you can upload an image or add an image using a web URL. You may add alt text or alternative text to briefly describe your image. We recommend adding an alt text description of your image so that anyone using a screen reader will know what the image is and how it relates to your portfolio. Click OK, and your image should show up in the body of your page. You can click on your image to get the editing tool and choose a different size. Make sure you save your page.